The Neko Light Orchestra, the musical collective, had the idea of doing a marathon. The Neko Light project is really interesting because there are so many musicians on stage, up to 13. So the goal was to recreate the musicians' stage positions to give a sense of depth of field, which is really difficult to do on a stereo system as we can't get the sensation of distance from the source, though there are some ways that all the sound engineers will know. I wanted to work in Immersive, but we could go one better and use WFS. I had no idea that it would be possible. For me, it was almost utopian. So we still had to define the number of sound sources that were going to enable us to do real WFS. As those who are interested in this technology will know, you need a certain number of speakers in order to create a credible experience. So we tried using 7 sources. Perhaps more would have been better, but nevertheless, it worked. I was confident from the offset. I even went out and bought the speakers in the week as I wanted to reproduce the experience and prepare the way ahead. Regarding the sound system, I used Karas in 7 clusters of 4 attached to a bridge in front of the stage, as well as Kivas in 7 stacks of 2 stacked on the stage. The Kiva stacks, of course, were on the same axes as the Kara clusters. For the mics and consoles, I used 2 Rio 3224Ds, a patch with 60 ins, and a CL5. The appeal of the CL5, of course, being the Dante network, which allows us to interface the SPAT Revolution on the MacBook Pro with a virtual Dante sound card. Using the direct outs, I sent nearly all the sources to the SPAT Revolution, excluding the more complex instruments that require several mics, such as the piano, the harp, or even the strings, on which I always have a DPA and a pickup. So the SPAT Revolution was receiving 50 audio channels, with SPAT's WFS audio engine itself generating 7 more that were attributed to each of the Kara clusters or Kiva stacks. The audio paths of the Dante and the SPAT Revolution passed through the Rio and hit the LA racks in AES. The appeal of the SPAT Revolution is to recreate a dimension. It's capable of generating a space, and in particular, the reverb linked to that space. This is something we can't do in a traditional concert with more standard tools. The concept is compatible with several audio interfaces. It works with Mac's core audio engine, so we can plug that into whatever we like, be it Dante, DigiGrid, or whatever. So we can install a small setup with ease. In about an hour, we can do what we want. I'm not suggesting that we can easily exhaust all of its possibilities, because obviously there are many, many parameters, but still, after 1 hour, we can create a setup that works. I have to say, I couldn't believe it. Straight away, the sensation is incredible, because we can make the sound sources all but disappear. Obviously, we're used to hearing the sound coming from the speakers, which is still the case, of course. This isn't magic. However, the speakers themselves disappear behind the sound field, that famous synthesized sound field. It's no longer the console doing the mixing or the summation, it's the SPAT. And the SPAT doesn't just do left-right summation, the SPAT does a virtual summation in a virtual space. Perhaps it's that that gives so much naturalness to the sources. That's the goal, in fact, to ensure that people are moved by the artist's emotions, and above all, to ensure that instead of having 15 or 20% of the audience in the center with good seats, you know what it's like. Here, I was walking about earlier, and I'm almost tempted to say that we have 100%. Perhaps I'm exaggerating a little to say that 100% of the audience zone is good, but I really have the impression that we're able to respect the image that we want to portray, no matter where we are, both in terms of depth and breadth. And that's really incredible, because I don't know of anything else that would be capable of doing that on such a large audience zone. So after all these hours of work, what I felt in the Flux studios, or at home even, I also felt here. Better even, inevitably. We don't have the same sound system. It's just incredible. I think that we go beyond that which we can do with stereo or other known systems. We go way beyond. It's gonna be tough to go back.